What's going on, everybody? It's your boy iPod King Carter here. I'm bringing you guys week 12 in my connected franchise with David iPod King Carter, my mobile QB. Now, I do want to update you guys on what's going on with me. I'm going to try to finish this game out. I know I'm going to be going to the playoffs, and my Eagles are already out of the playoffs in real life, but I'm going to go ahead and live through Madden, baby. The Madden gods can give me what I want. Now, getting into the game, first possession, I want to get DeMarco Murray in the game because I feel like in real life, he hasn't been in the game. You know, they made this dude damn near third, fourth string running back. And for whatever reason, Chip Kelly just said, you know what, we're not going to utilize him for his skills. We're not going to add plays to our playbook. And I think that's why that man got fired. Yeah, man, F what's going on the screen. You guys can watch the gameplay, but I'm here to rant about the Eagles. This is one of those videos where I feel like I can get my feelings off my chest, you know, because most of the time when I'm playing these games, I'm playing for the gameplay, I'm playing for the entertainment, I'm playing for you guys. But this time, this video is all about me. It's time for me to snap out. First of all, I don't know what in the hell was going on with Chip Kelly at all when he came to the Eagles. Now, granted, I did love the way that they kept the ball moving, they kept the chains moving, and they kept the plays going. You know, with every snap, you're like, God, they're getting back to the line so quick, they're getting plays off so quick. But what in the hell happened to this dude sending off the entire offense? Literally, he let almost everybody go. Besides the offensive line, he damn near let everybody go. Like, I'm talking about wide receivers, running backs, quarterbacks. He let these dudes go. People that literally went 10-6 for him for two straight seasons. I just simply can't understand why we sat through that. I don't understand why the owners, anybody from the staff let that go down. Okay, now a lot of people say, well, he was coach GM. Cool, he was coach GM, but what in the type of GM does that? The only other GM that I know do stuff like that is Sam Hinkie. Oh, okay, I'm sorry. I don't want to go in a rant about the Sixers because that doesn't even deserve a rant. We only got two wins on the board. But back to these Eagles, though. So, okay, coach GM, you go ahead and let go McCoy. You let go of Deshaun. Now, the Deshaun problem, I really didn't understand it at first, and then when they start putting out all the news reports, I was like, man, they trying to paint this man bad. They trying to paint this dude bad. So at the end of the day, I don't understand why they let him go and why they couldn't just deal with that internally. Then, you know, you let McCoy go, you let Foles go, you let all these dudes go, and I'm like, all right, so why are we like literally? You let go of the entire running back like roster, like you damn near rebuilt the running back roster. You know what I'm saying? You bring in Sproles, you bring in DeMarco, and you didn't add any eye formation to your playbook. You didn't take anything. Okay, how can you watch a team like Dallas be so successful with a running back like DeMarco Murray and not steal some plays? Not even borrow, not even take. How couldn't you steal some of these plays that they built for this man to make him a successful running back? I feel like they overloaded on running backs just to say, well, we're going to have the best running game in the NFL. When that's a goddamn lie. That's a goddamn lie. Why don't you just keep McCoy? Okay, I could have understood the, you know, the Sproles move. Okay, bring him in with Ryan Matthews. Whenever, oh, sorry about that fumble, by the way. But whenever LeSean gets tired or whatever, you can bring in those guys and let them work. Let them eat. But you bring in DeMarco that doesn't even fit in our system. And say, yeah, we're gonna go ahead and pay this man whatever he wants, but we're gonna put him at fourth string, though. We're not gonna utilize him at all. Now, let's talk about the quarterback situation. Okay, you got Sam Bradford. Cool. My man is injury prone. Granted, it's cool. You got Mark Sanchez. What in the fuck is you thinking about? Secondly, you let go of Tim Tebow, which I think would have been a better fit than Mark Sanchez, because nobody on the Eagles roster wants to play for Mark Sanchez at all. Nobody wants to play for this dude. So whenever he comes in the game, they're like, I'm not putting my life on the line. I'm not going to chance getting injured. I'm not going to play because Mark Sanchez isn't going to get the job done. He has nothing to offer. Nothing. Just like Aguilar on that play right there. Why couldn't my man catch that pass for that touchdown? What the heck is he doing? Matter of fact, by the way, I'm playing on all Madden. Your boy bumped up the difficulty. I was tripping in the last video, breaking touchdown passes, records and all that. But yeah, we playing on all Madden. But back to these Eagles, though. So, with the wide receiver positions. Okay, you got Deshaun leaving. You know what I'm saying? Macklin left on his own accord because he wanted to go home. He got offered the bread, and you guys didn't offer nothing back at all. And I don't even think that the counter offer was even like noteworthy. Like, they don't even want me. So basically, you let Macklin go. They had a breakaway season after coming back off an injury, and then you know you get these new wide receivers, you get these new young guys. You know what I'm saying? But you're letting these young guys go, you know, back to back. Like, you know, you got Austin, you got all these guys, but you're letting dudes go, like, since they're not fitting in your offense for Sam Bradford. Whereas, though, you could have got another quarterback, somebody more noteworthy than Sam Bradford, and let him eat. And, okay, Sam Bradford, beginning of the season, pissed me off. Middle of the season, pissed me off. Towards the end of the season, I start getting pissed off at the wide receivers because I'm like, yo, he's putting the ball where it needs to be, but these dudes ain't catching balls. Pause. They're not catching balls. And I'm trying to figure out why they're not catching balls. It's because nobody wants to play, dog. And I just thought about it. I just said, you know what? It ain't Sam Bradford. It ain't Mark Sanchez. It ain't none of the running backs, none of the wide receivers, none of the defense. Nobody wants to play for Chip Kelly. It's that plain and simple, dog. Chip Kelly out here making terrible decisions. He's taking the blame every game, and he's confident about his team and what they can do, but our team is not producing. It makes no sense how you're a coach saying, it's your fault, we got a good roster, but we can't get things done. What do you mean we can't get things done? How are you not putting your foot on these dudes' neck, making them better? How are you not advancing dudes' player development as a coach? Nobody understands what's going on in Philly, how we took a terrible dive, and then the division we're in. Oh my God, the division we are in. We should have been cakewalking like how Cam Newton cakewalked when he went to the playoffs and then had no wins out here in these streets. I don't understand how we couldn't make it to the playoffs as a team like us. Like, Cowboys, injury prone. New York, buns. How the fuck does Washington clinch a playoff run when they were the worst team the season prior in our division? Makes no sense, bruh. No sense at all. Like, it pisses me off to even think about what in the world happened. Like, I'm just happy that Chip Kelly got the boot. I'm happy that the Eagles organization, as a unit, decided this man deserved the boot. Because I just couldn't understand how, in the last game, prior to, you know, the last week, he really said, well, if I have to worry about my job security, I should have already been gone. And he said it in such of a cocky way, like, I ain't going nowhere. Y'all gonna get this next season and the season after that up out of me. This contract extension I'm about to be fired. Like, that's what we really thought was about to happen. And I'm like, I can't take it. I can't take another year of Chip Kelly fucking up our offense and defense. Even Peters, he straight up said he sat himself out and said, I'm not going to force an injury for a non-playoff squad, bruh. That's when you know players do not want to play for their coach. It ain't about the offense. It ain't about the defense. It's about the coaching staff, bro. And Chip Kelly, my man, I chuck the deuce to you, bro. Go back to college. Take that crazy shit you got going on back over to college. You know what I'm saying? Let us big boys play with our big toys. Because you out here effing up everything, bro. You supposed to revolutionize the whole, like, shit. You supposed to be the next, I don't know. I don't want to name no great coaches because you ain't a great coach. I ain't even going to tarnish their name with your name. But you was supposed to be one of the great ones. That's what everybody was talking about. You supposed to be one of the ones, but you ain't, bruh. But this game is over, man. I'm glad I got my rant out. I'm glad I got it off my chest. Make sure you like the video. Subscribe if you're new to my channel. Man, I'm going to holla at y'all in the next one, man. This is IKC signing. I'm pissed and happy at the same time. Yeah.